is these two provisions are the problem. Why Arvind Kejriwal did not get the bail yesterday? Why he could not get the bail? Because Pamela mein bail milta hi nahi hai. This law was made to deal with money laundering. And I told you, proving the traces of money laundering is virtually impossible. Bahut mushkil hota hai. Until unless there is a lot of investigation and lot of efforts and lot of luck of the investigation agency. Pata nahi lagta economic crimes ka. Bahut mushkil hai pata lagana. In that scenario, these provisions are the reason that Kejriwal will never get the bail. Because the reason is, this law is reversed. चलिए तो let us look at some news. तो some events we have covered here. Let's see. So the four news that we will cover today: money laundering, global happiness index, gender inequality index, and regulatory sandbox. Money laundering. This is important for your two papers. three papers. SAM में there may be a question on money laundering. GS paper 3 में it's a proper chapter on money laundering. Internal security. There's a full-fledged chapter there plus governance. So it's the issue which can be found at three different places. The governance, GS paper 2, internal security, GS paper 3, ethics as well as essays. Essay interview में तो common है ये. ठीक है तो it's the important news. I have always said whenever there is a political news in current affairs, do not cover it. UPSC will never ask politically charged question. वो कभी नहीं पूछेंगे arrest of Arvind Kejriwal. How? What do you believe? ऐसा कोई question कभी नहीं आएगा. But understand the constitutional and legal background. If he has been arrested, remove the political angle. Modi ji has arrested him during election year. Soft dictatorship drama. नहीं. Understand the legal background. Why he has been arrested? What is the menace? What is the legal and constitutional framework? That we need to understand. So we know that the Chief Minister of Delhi, Arvind Kejriwal, has been arrested by the ED, Enforcement Directorate, under PAMLA, Prevention of Money Laundering Act, in connection with money laundering case related to liquor scam. So basically, at this point, you need to understand that policy making is always an exclusive function of the government. Government every time make policies, it benefits some people, it harms some people. There's no problem in that. For example, you have decided, institute said that they will provide you class in morning. It's the most suitable time to you. But for some reason, the institute changed the class timing from morning to evening. It may be inconvenience for you, but may be convenience for other people. So when I change a policy, it always harms few and benefits few. It always happens. But the problem here is not the policy change. The accusation is that this policy was changed to benefit few people only. That too for particular reasons. That is the blame. Whether the ED will be able to prove it or not, we don't know at this point of time. But generally, aisa hota bhi nahi hai. Because financial crimes are very hard to prove. Apart from the political dimension that why Modi does not take action on their BJP people, वो सब हमारा कंसर्न नहीं है बिकॉज दैट इज नॉट गोना आस्क इन यूपीएससी. सो अंडरस्टैंड द मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग ड्रामा एंड व्हाट इज दिस पैमला एंड ईडी. सो एज सून एज यू हियर दिस न्यूज, पॉलिटिकली चार्ज्ड न्यूज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट, बट यू नीड टू नो व्हाट इज ईडी, हाउ इट वर्क्स, व्हाट आर द रोल, व्हाट इज द फंक्शन, व्हाट इज पैमला, व्हाट इज इट्स रोल इन द इकोनॉमिक हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडिया, इट्स रोल इन एंश्योरिंग इकोनॉमिक प्रोबिटी एंड एथिक्स इन इंडिया एंड रिलेटेड टू पॉलिसीज. सो दिस थिंग यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड. चलिए पहला देख लेते हैं मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग. Basically, what is money laundering? As the name itself implies, laundering. The way you launder the clothes, you make dirty clothes good. Same is money laundering, where you make dirty money good money, simply stating. The process of hiding the source of illegally obtained money by camouflaging it as sourced from legitimate. So that is basically money laundering. Simply, if you have to write, you can define money laundering as the process of converting illegitimate money into legitimate money by using various mechanisms, various methods, simply stating. Of course, it endangers the stability of the economy. Money laundering is very dangerous. It allows corruption, and understand, everyone is involved. You cannot blame one party and another party. Sabhi ek hi thali ke chatte batte hain. Jaise, for example, in previous classes, we discussed electoral bond. इलेक्ट्रोल बॉन्ड में भी यही एक्यूजिशन है. that Modi government brought electoral bond. ADCBI conducted raid on some companies, and after that they purchased bond and gave to BJP. So it is also can be seen, but thing is ADCBI is right now under the union government. So unke khilaf aise bhi koi action hona nahi. So that is the main point that is being disputed. That you are selectively targeting. 95% of cases of ED is on opposition leaders. I'm not saying they are false. What I'm saying is they are selective. It's very clear. It's clear as the water itself. Yes, the action of ED is very selective. CBI is very selective, particularly regarding opposition. Ye to clear baat hai. So having said that, let's understand the three stages of money laundering. There are three stages in money laundering. Number one, placement. Means putting the illegitimate money into proper financial channels. Second, layering. That is moving the money rapidly so that it cannot be traced. So you got the illegal money, illegitimate money. First, you place it in any of the formal channels. Second stage, mein, you move that money so rapidly that it is untraceable, known as layering. Last is integration, means bringing the money back to you. Now it's a legitimate money. Let me take an example. For example, Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana. Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana, under Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana, a large number of accounts have been opened. A large number of accounts, zero balance account they are known as. This scheme has been continuing since the Manmohan Singh time. Modi renamed it Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana. Earlier it was known as Swabhiman, another scheme. So a large number of accounts have been opened, but not everyone use a bank account. Large number of people, particularly, they do not use bank account. That's the catch. Account hai unke naam pe, par use nahin karte. Around 98% of India's population, according to government's claim, has bank account. Largely under Jan Dhan Yojana, zero balance account. But still a large number of people, particularly the elderly, they still don't like this electronic transaction mechanism. They are still into cash. And they largely do not believe in bank savings. So large number of accounts, around 30 to 40% of Jan Dhan account are laying empty. Now imagine you are a banker. Still, I told you, the richest people on earth are bankers. Because they move money from here to there. They live in money. They basically dive in money. So it depends upon how skilled you are. You're skilled, then moving money here and there is an easy topic. So now imagine you're a branch manager, and in your branch, let's say it's in a village and you have around 20-30 accounts, Jan Dhan. On a level or on the level of state, you have 2,000, 3,000, 4,000 accounts only in your district. What you will do? You will enter into an agreement with black money holders. Koi bhi ho sakta hai, political party, businessman, common people. They will come to you, give you money. You will take a cut and deposit that money into Jan Dhan accounts. Because if you deposit money less than 50,000, you does not require to provide PAN card, Aadhaar card, whatever. Up to 50,000, generally 49,000, you can deposit money without proof. So what they do is, they deposit less than 50,000. Amal lete your 2,000 account. So you can deposit 49,000 in each account. Crores of rupees you deposit it. Easily. Lakhs of rupees at least you deposit it. That's how. And you take a part of it. That is one mechanism. So you brought cash to me, illegitimate money. I put that into Jan Dhan account. That is placement. After that, I cannot keep that money in Jan Dhan account. I have to move it around. From this account to that account, that account to that account. It has to go in a circles into different channels and mechanism. Let's say, from this Jan Dhan account, I will make a payment to somebody else's account, which is a functional account, properly functional account. From that functional account, I will transfer it to some other account. From that account, I will transfer it to some other account. This is called layering. That is moving money so fast that government cannot catch it. Last, after moving it through number of accounts or number of mechanisms, the money will be given back to me through a proper channel like check, DD or whatever. So I illegitimate money. Say for example, I give 2 lakh rupees to a bank manager. He will convert and give me at least 1.5 lakh rupees. So at a 50,000 rupee cost that will be distributed among everyone, I converted my 2 lakh rupee into a legitimate looking 1.5 lakh rupees. That is called money laundering. We will discuss other channels also. Bahut channels hai iske. So this is the three stage. Please remember that there are three stages of money laundering: placement, layering, and integration. Integration. Integration means bringing the money back to the person who brought the money. I brought the cash to you. You are a bank manager. You will deposit that money into Jandan account. That is placement. Then that money will be moved into different accounts. It will not stay at a place. That is layering. After that, you will give that money back to me through official mechanism. DD, demand draft, check, or any other mechanism. Electronic transfer. Jo bhi hoga, you will give that money to me. This is legitimately recorded money. That is called integration. Okay, so these are the three stages of money laundering. Abo. Yes, Rahul, you are asking something. Which stated hard? I don't get the point. What are you asking? Achha, which stage is hard out of these? Haan, usme main aa raha hun. The biggest and the, this is here. Placement is the hardest one. Baki asaan hote hain. If you catch the money at the placement stage, you can recover the money. We will understand how it works and how come no institution can do about anything about this. Samjhenge bhi kaise hota hai ye. So ek tarika maine aapko bata hi diya. The thing is, placement is the most critical stage. If you can find out at the placement level, then you can catch the money. Once it is placed properly, it is gone. Then aapke papa bhi nahi pata laga payenge money kahan gaya. You cannot find out where the money went once it is in placement. So if you want to find the money, you must find in placement level itself. And here comes PAMLA, Prevention of Money Laundering Act, PAMLA. What it says is, a provision we will discuss in a bit, that every financial institution, XYZ, every financial institution shall inform, there's a body under PAMLA known as Financial Intelligence Unit, FIU. It is in the notes, I will tell you where. Every financial authority, banks, RBI, SEBI, any institution that deals with finance, private or government, they all must report their transaction which they feel suspicious. It may not be bad, but suspicious to the Financial Intelligence Unit. Then FIU vets that transaction. So you, Malate, you're a general manager in SBI. You find there is a transaction which you believe has some fishy parameters. You will send that transaction to FIU. FIU then check that transaction, see the parameters. And if FIU, prima facie, on the first sight, believes that yes, there is a problem in this, then it will refer that to ED, Enforcement Directorate. Investigate this. That's how the stages work. So PAMLA basically aims at here. But phir repeat kar raha, I'm repeating this again. Once you place the money in the system, it's done. It's unable to be traced. The only stage you can trace money is here. Layering bit is the purpose of layering is to avoid trace. That's why it is moved around. Integration mein to yaar it is coming from genuine sources. So usme to koi kuch nahi kar sakta. Theek hai? Now let us see some mechanism. So there are some mechanism in which money laundering happens. Pehla hawala. Hawala transaction known as underground banking. Isme you can take a pride that it was coined, it was initiated in India. Hawala. It's a basically Indian word. So India and Pakistan, because at that point of time it was United India. So we coined this mechanism. How it works, let's see. Padh lena what is written there. Let me tell you how it works. There is a very simple mechanism of it. There is a person here known as Hawala Broker 1. Let's say this Hawala Broker 1 is in India. There will be another person. Let's say Hawala Broker 2. Let's suppose this person is in USA. United States of America. So what will happen? I, as an Indian person, I have black money. Black money means any money on which taxes are not paid. That is illegitimate money. If you have paid the taxes, it's legitimate money. Illegal means under the law it is prohibited. And I told you illegal is time specific. So basically when we all the people we agreed to the constitution of India known as the contract. मैंने आपको समझाया था. Constitution is a type of contract. That's why the first line of Indian constitution is we the people of India. It is a political fiction that all the people of India have come together, discussed, debate and created a basic framework to govern all of us. That is known as constitution. So under constitution, when we created state, we chose constituent assembly members. Those members on behalf of us made the constitution. Under that constitution, we have made the state. State means government, that is executive, legislature and judiciary. They all are made under the constitution, which represent the will of the people. So under that will, we said that the government has all the powers. Then government asks the question, yeah, how would I run? You have created me. How would I run? Then we answered. We said, okay, fine. You will have the right to tax. To understand, you cannot say no to taxes because you have already agreed to it under the constitution. Fiction samajh mein aaya? Because government says, how would I run myself? So humne bola, okay, fine. Under the constitution, we are giving you authority to impose taxes on us. From that money, you can run yourself. So basically, illegitimate money or black money is any money on which taxes, which is a legitimate claim of the government or the state from your money under the constitution is not paid. Simply understand. So let's say I have 20 crore rupees as illegitimate money or the money on which I did not pay the taxes. I will take this 20 crore to this Hawala Broker 1. This Hawala Broker 1 will say, say for example, he say I take 10% as the commission. So it means out of 20 crore, how much would I receive? 18 crore. 2 crore will be kept by Hawala Broker 1. Why he is taking 10%? वैसे इतना होता नहीं है. Depend करता है what kind of transaction. The higher the transaction, the less is the amount. But let's suppose the reason is because he is taking risk. You are not taking any risk. He is taking all the risk. He will place, layer and then integrate. You are just taking the money to him. So to do this activity of placement, layer and integration, he charged a part. ठीक है? What he will do? He will make a call to Hawala agent B, Hawala broker B or agent B. He will make a call to an American Hawala broker B. He will say to this person, please issue 18 crore rupees equivalent dollars. Issue 18 crore rupees equivalent dollars to the X person. Ab who is this X person? He may be a person related to this, his other agent, broker, jo bhi ho sakta, or this X person may be related to him. That could be any relation. In America. Baat samajh mein aaya? So I took the money to Hawala Broker 1. Hawala Broker 1 will make a call to Hawala Broker 2 and say, I have received 20 crore rupees. Our, matlab yours and my commission combined is 2 crore. The remaining 80 crore, you have to convert into dollar. And give that to this person through official channels, means through bank account or jo bhi America mein financial tools are there. After that, this person will transfer that money to my account. So money is changing place, but only at what stage? Once. Generally, but kai baar ye bhi nahi hota hai. Kyun? Because obviously baat hai, most of the hawala transactions are carried out by businesses. Individual nahi karte, hum pe paisa hi nahi hai itna. What businesses do? I am here and I have a business in USA that need money. If I take my rupee to USA, the government of India and the government of America will come to know about the money and they will charge me. Government of India can start investigation or whatever. So what I do is, I give 20 crore to Hawala agent B or Hawala broker B. This person makes a call to Hawala broker 2 in USA and asks the US broker to give equivalent amount of dollars to my company in America. So it appears as if this person has made an investment in my company. Maybe he buys shares, he buys bonds. Anyway, sabko samajh mein aaya na, how does it works? This is a understand how can I catch the money which never crossed borders. Isliye hawala is untraceable. Untraceable, it is functioning even today and everyone knows it. everyone. It is uncatchable mechanism because money, the illegitimate money, never crosses border. Now, a question may come to your mind, natural question. What about this Hawala broker too? Why he will give the money? Because somebody will do the same in America. There is a person, American citizen, US too, say for example. This person will go to this person, give him dollars. And he will make a call to this person. And he will give equivalent amount of dollar to the relative of US too person. So it goes to and fro. From India to America, from America to India. It keeps on going like this. Here and there, here and there. And that's why the money never crosses border. When money never crosses border, how can you catch it? That's a Hawala is a foolproof money laundering mechanism. Clear? A question may emerge in your mind. Ek to tarika ye hai, he will, to he got 20 crore rupees. This crore rupees he will not keep. He will keep his part. The remaining part he will give to some other person on the basis of Hawala broker too. How inflow money to USA? I don't get the point. Money never crosses border. Isme. The only thing that crosses border is this part. This part is legitimate money because it is coming from official mechanism. Sabse zyada paisa pata kahan aata hai? Share market. Let's take an example. It is being accused. Nobody knows it clearly. It is being accused in case of a person called Mr. Adani. That Hindenburg report. That report argued that Mr. Adani used Hawala to transfer large amount of his money from India to Mauritius. And from Mauritius, it was invested as genuine investment in his shareholdings. So, I have illegitimate money. I cannot buy shares. Of course, I cannot buy shares. Government will ask, kahan se laya paisa? So, what I do, I take convert that money from Indian rupee through Hawala to Mauritius currency. And somebody in Mauritius, Adani has a lot of relatives there. So somebody in Mauritius, maybe my relative, my friend, my business partner, that person from Mauritius will buy my shares by proper bank account. That's how this Hawala works. Share market, bond market. Isliye maine aapko starting mein bola tha. If you're a banker and that you're a smart banker, there is no limit of money you can print at home. The richest people on earth are bankers. For example, very good name is JP Morgan. JP Morgan became so big. He was a merchant banker. Merchant banker means the banker who play with share market. This person became so big, he funded the entire government of America in war. Entire government ko fund kar diya usne. He has so much of money. Then ultimately, government of America established Federal Reserves. It is like RBI. They did not have a regulator at that point of time in banking. So everyone was doing whatever they like. After this JP Morgan drama, they installed and they created a regulator in banking. They came to know it is very bad. That's how it works. Isliye dekhi, money ka pata lagana asaan nahi hota. Money is invisible. It crosses border without anyone noticing. It is not people crossing border. It is not goods crossing border. It's basically invisible transaction. Dekhi, call hui hai bas yahan pe. Simple call. Koi bhi kar sakta hai. Call mein, main thoda sun raha hu aapki call mein kya chal raha hai. It's untraceable. This is one mechanism known as Hawala. Isme aap padhenge, economy mein padhaya jata P-notes. Chaliye anyway. Pehla Hawala samajh mein aaya? Let me make it a bit complex and introduce another thing known as P-notes. Let's see how P-notes work. Any question to anyone? Well, so don't worry, it will be taught again in GS paper 3 money laundering. Ab you may feel bad. You may be like, yeah, this is the wrong. Hai. A common person, if does not pay taxes, government, income tax department comes to the home. If big companies do not pay taxes, they got scot-free. What is this drama? That's how the incidents work. That's why I told you, if you want to be a criminal, that's why I always say, na, if you want to become a criminal, become a constitutional thief. Theek hai? Nobody can trace it. Chaliye, samajhte hain. Same Hawala mein, what happens is, there is a Hawala broker or Hawala agent one. I say, for example, is a XYZ company. I want somebody to invest in my shares, but I cannot. So what I will do, I will give cash to this Hawala agent one. This person will make a call to any country. That is the problem. That is something we call foreign direct investment. It is being blamed that 80% of FDI in India is basically round tipping of money. It's Indian money which goes through offshore through hawala agents and then come back in India as a FDI, foreign direct investment. It's a proper channel. So FDI mein paisa aata hai. Jaise for example, there are country, aapka Dubai, UAE, these countries never asked from where you are bringing the money. If you are bringing in the real estate sectors, they never ask this money. Kahin se bila, I don't care, I need money. Same, aisa nahi hai, before calling them bad people, understand, I have always told you, what is illegal is time specific. Depends which time you live in and what kind of person you are. Everything is very time specific. Now let's understand this illegal drama. So he will make a call to this hawala broker one. Two, he will give money to any XYZ two person. This person has few options. Because this is layering and placement. Now I want integration. Means I want this money back to me. How can I get it? Numerous mechanism. He will do FDI, foreign direct investment. He will invest in my, for example, share market, bond market. He will start joint venture with me. Jo bhi case hoga, I will receive the FDI. Second, he can buy. There's something called P notes. P notes means participatory notes. They were allowed in India's share market. How they works? UPSC asked directly a question in prelims. What is the full form of P notes? So the answer was participatory notes. How they work? Because under SEBI regulation, SEBI is the regulator of the share market. Under SEBI regulation, if anyone wants to invest in India's share market, they must be registered with SEBI. If you want to invest, you must be registered with Security and Exchange Board of India. It's the regulator of share market. You must be registered. Let's say you don't want to register. Aapko pasand nahi hai. So kya karoge? There was an option, P notes. In this, it says any company, any financial investor. Say, for example, America mein, you have a company called ABC. It is registered with SEBI. Matlab, it can invest in India's share market. It can buy a share of any company from India's share market. So, P notes mein kya hota hai? Under SEBI regulation, this ABC company can issue a P note to any person. Repeat karta hun. You took a cash, gave to this hawala agent. He made a call. Equivalent amount of money was given to this person. This person will go to ABC company and buy their P notes. P notes is like just electoral bonds that do not bear the name of the person and the source of income. Means when this ABC company issues P notes to this person, they do not have to mention who bought it and from what money. Was it cash? Was it electronic? From where this money came? And then you can take this P note and invest in India's share market. It was like bond system. A question ye hai. We allowed this. And everyone knew this was a round tipping of money. Then why we allowed this? Because India is a developing country and we need a large amount of money. SEBI thought, I know that a large number of P note could be black money doing the round tipping. But nonetheless, it is increasing India's share market capacity. We allowed P notes. Ye jante hue bhi that P notes was like bond, electoral bonds that do not bear the source of income information. So anyone can buy them in cash, even if that cash is from Hawala. You give cash in rupees to this person, he will make a call. He will give cash in dollars to this person. He will buy the P notes, invest in your share market. Basically, he will buy your shares. So you will receive the money. So aapke share ka price bhi badh jayega because there will be too many demand. So share ka price same is being blamed for Adani. This is what he said Adani did. Nobody knows clearly, but it is being accused. Yeah, that clear? Recent mein SEBI has introduced KYC norm in P note. Matlab, now to issue P notes, every foreign company must perform KYC. Matlab, know your customer. It means they must reveal who bought this P notes from what source of money. Par ye humne ab kara. Pehle nahi. Simple reason main aapko bataya, because India was a developing country. 1960s, 70s mein we were very weak. We needed money. So we were like, we know this is round-tipped money, but let it be. Nonetheless, it's the money. It will help us develop. Now we are sufficiently developed. Share market, India share market is very well developed. So we thought it's high time we stop this illegitimate money. Clear? This is hawala and combined with other mechanisms. This is one way of and the most effective way of money laundering. Most efficient. It is being performed even today right now. And nobody can capture this money. At most, aap kya kar sakte hain? Aap ise pakad sakte hain. If the police can find out hawala broker, then they can find out kisne cash diya, kisne diya. But hawala broker never maintain records. Ye thodi na ki aapne 20 lakh diye hain, to main aapka naam rakhunga apne paas. Why would a hawala agent will maintain records who gave the money? So often hawala agents are arrested. This is the guarantee na. Why he is charging 10%? Isliye to charge kar raha hai wo. Even if police arrests me, your name will never come forward. I will take the blame entirely. Aur waise bhi please keep in mind, sab police walon ko pata hai. Jaise for example in Karol Bagh, you go to this market, there are a lot of hawala agents. I know them. Theek hai? There are a lot of hawala agents. I have seen hawala transaction. A lot of them. Ab jab mujhe pata hai, so imagine the police does not know this. They get a cut. Of course they get a cut. And why they don't care? Because you are a small policeman. Chudde se policeman ho. This is a global network. Kya bigaad loge tum? Theek hai? Clear? And on politicians, big parties, IAS officers, judges, they use hawala mechanism to convert their money. But again, not everyone. They are good people also. Aisa nahi ki har koi corrupt hai. But nonetheless, people use it. Anyway, clear all the side mechanism number one. Let's see second mechanism. The second mechanism is known as transfer pricing. So first mechanism is hawala or underground broking. I have told you what is the drama. Next mechanism is transfer pricing. What is transfer pricing and how it works? Understand. Majority of the transactions in the world, and every company is blamed for this. Google, Apple, Amazon, Facebook, everyone is blamed for transfer pricing. How does it work? If you have seen a movie made in India known as Guru, this is said that it is loosely based on Dhirubhai Ambani, the father of Mukesh Ambani. It is said it is loosely based on him. Nobody knows the reality. It's a prediction. How does it work, transfer pricing? You are a company. Let's say you are a Vedanta, it's a real company. Let's take any company, X company. It is registered in Mauritius. Yeah, US kahin bhi. It is registered in Mauritius. Means its headquarters is in Mauritius. There are a lot of companies, you notice this. They work in India, but their headquarters or registered office is not in India. They often register themselves in tax havens. Why? Because Mauritius impose corporate tax. Let me assume 0.5%. Generally, these countries are very small. And they need a lot of money. So they don't care whether this money is legitimate or not. And they often do not charge taxes from the corporate. It's often the scenario. They are known as tax havens. Like Switzerland example. What will happen? This X company registered in Mauritius will have another company known as X1. It is known as subsidiary. This is parent company. This is subsidiary. So on one side you have parent, other side you have the subsidiary. This subsidiary is registered in India. As per Indian laws, as per Income Tax Act, and if any company in India earns profit, they have to pay corporate tax. Currently, corporate tax in India is 25% for the old and around 15% for the new. Hayalaki, it is very low. Around the world, it is very low. Since Modi government has come into power, I told you it's a very corporate-friendly government. It's a neoliberal government. So they have reduced corporate tax a lot. Anyway, 25% corporate tax in India for old firm and 16% or 15% around for new firm. Let's say this company earned 20 crore rupees profit. On 20 crore, it has to pay taxes 25%. Like this is the income of this company. Of what this company will do, the subsidiary, it will place an order to its parent company. Because what is my profit? Profit is basically, or income, profit is basically whatever I earn and whatever the expenditure. I earn 100 rupees and I spend 20 rupees. So what is my profit? 80 rupees is my extra money. So what they do is they increase their expenditure. Isse kya hoga? Profit kam ho jayega. Let's say I place an order of 18 crore rupees to my parent company, because legally speaking, this company and this company are different. It's an Indian registered, it's Mauritius registered. Although it is a parent company, but nonetheless, legally speaking, they are different. This company is liable to pay taxes only in Mauritius. This company is liable to pay taxes only in India on its income because it's Indian registered. So this company will place an order of 18 crore rupees to its parent. This money is known as transfer pricing. Its advantage kya hua? 20 crore profit minus my 18 crore rupees I place an order. What is my profit? On 2 crores, I will pay 25% taxes. Now you will say 18 crore rupees I transferred to this company. So it is an expenditure of company. It is an expenditure of company X1. But it is the income of company X. But yahan pe tax kitna hai? 0.5. So rather than paying 25% on 18 crore rupees, I paid only 0.5. This is known as transfer pricing. Let's suppose ab aap kahenge, government of India is that stupid. This is not problem of government of India, it's the problem around the world. Every country suffers. For example, current president Joe Biden of America, former president Donald Trump, even before him, Barack Obama, they all said this multiple times that the companies of America do not pay taxes in America. They play this mechanism. Apple, Google, sab pe blame hai. According to International Monetary Fund, global organization, around 60% to 70% of world trade is within companies. These are known as multinational companies, MNCs. That's how they save billions of dollars or rupees in taxes. So, aisa nahi hai, America ko fayda ho raha hai, kisi ko fayda nahi ho raha. Except some tax havens, aur sabse zyada fayda to inhi ka hai. Anyway, ab aap question karenge, bhai, I place 18 crore rupees order, to Bharat Sarkar ne check nahi kara ki paisa kuch aaya ya nahi aaya. Isliye I told you the reference of that movie. What will happen? This company will send, it will send something because order place to kuch to aayega. It will send empty cartoons. That is what was shown in the Guru movie. This movie mein yehi dikhaya tha. What that person does, he places an order to the foreign companies. The foreign company sends empty cartoon. They will bribe port official in Mauritius and they will bribe port officials in India. The port official of Mauritius will say that 18 crore rupees stuff has gone from Mauritius port. The port in India will say 18 crore rupees stuff has come into the Mauritius port. And that is why there was a criticism of giving ports to Adani. Adani has the largest port in India right now in Gujarat. And wahan pe crores and crores rupees of drugs have been discovered multiple times. But news ko cover nahi karti, wo ek alag baat hai. Ab you are a corporate, you have port as well. तो आपको बराबर करने की जरूरत ही नहीं है ठीक है एनीवे सो एम्प्टी कार्टून डू कम सो देयर इज अ रजिस्टर एट मॉरिशियस एंड अब ऑब्वियसली बात है भाई गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया प्रधानमंत्री मोदी विल हिमसेल्फ डज नॉट गो टू अ पोर्ट टू चेक दे विल डिपेंड अपॉन द ऑफिशियल रिपोर्ट बाय द लोअर ऑफिसर्स इसीलिए द मोस्ट ल्यूक्रेटिव अगर आपको करप्शन में इंटरेस्ट है द मोस्ट ल्यूक्रेटिव पोजिशन इन सिविल सर्विसेज इज इंडियन रेवेन्यू सर्विस कस्टम एंड सेंट्रल एक्साइज दो है आपके पास IAS, IPS तो बंगा रहे हैं पैसा कमाने में अगर बिना झंझट के IAS, IPS में यू कैन अर्न अ लॉट ऑफ मनी बट झंझट बहुत रहता है यू आर टू मच विजिबल IAS, IPS आर टू मच विजिबल एवरीवन नोज देम योर डीएम ऑफ द डिस्ट्रिक्ट सब पता है सबको पता है कौन है किसी को नहीं पता होगा पोर्ट का कौन है एवरीवन नो हु इज द डीएम इवन इफ इट इज अ पोर्ट सिटी उन्हें नहीं पता होगा कि पोर्ट का इंचार्ज कौन है ओनली कंपनीज नोज तो यू डोंट इंटरेक्ट कॉमन पीपल थोड़ा एक्सपोर्ट इंपोर्ट कराएंगे You interact with companies and companies are very willing to pay money. आम लोग झंझट करते हैं 200 रुपए देने में. Company easily दे देती है. Because if it will give you 2 crore rupees as bribe, it will make you work for 200 crore rupees. It's a facilitation money. Company defend भी करती है और it's the most lucrative position. Most lucrative. पैसा ही पैसा और झंझट कम है. Nobody can know this. Anyway, clear this much? अब there is another problem. In era of information technology ye bhi zarurat nahi hai you can say I have placed an order of 18 crore rupees for softwares of softwares are given to a mail attachment of software ko main kaise verify karunga so you will say I have bought microsoft office for 18 crore rupees for my entire company theek hai bhai receipt dikha do hame and you will show the receipt टेस्ट देख लिए, माइक्रोसॉफ्ट की रसीद देख लो, दैट्स हाउ दिस ट्रांसफर प्राइसिंग वर्क्स. क्लियर है? ऐसा नहीं, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया हैज टेकन सम एफर्ट्स इन दिस, समथिंग नोन एज एडवांस प्राइसिंग अग्रीमेंट. गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया सेज, इफ यू गिव मी अ पार्ट ऑफ द ट्रांजेक्शन एज टैक्सेस, आई विल नॉट वेरीफाई द ट्रांजेक्शन. मतलब इफ यू पे अ पार्ट, इट वेरीज, करंटली इट इज अराउंड 20 to 30, इसलिए काम नहीं कर रहा. गवर्नमेंट कहता है गिव मी अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस ट्रांजेक्शन एज टैक्सेस एंड आई विल नॉट गो इन डिटेल्स हाउ मच यू अर्न. तो आसान है सरकार के लिए. क्या होगा? दे विल गो इन टू दिस ट्रांजेक्शन, देन यू विल गो टू कोर्ट, दे विल गो टू कोर्ट, दे विल स्पेंड 2,000 crore rupees जस्ट टू गेट 18 crore rupees बैक. अंडरस्टैंड, गवर्नमेंट नहीं करना चाहती, इट्स टू मच हेडेक. एंड एनी वे द फाइनेंशियल लॉज, मैंने बताया ना, इट्स हार्ड टू प्रूफ बिकॉज ये कंपनी मॉरिशियस में है. इफ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया वॉन्ट्स टू प्रूफ देयर इज अ करप्शन, इट हैज टू अरेस्ट दिस कंपनी, ऑफिशियल ऑफ दिस कंपनी. वो तो है ही नहीं इंडिया में. They are not Indian citizens. They are Mauritius citizens. Government of India cannot arrest Mauritius citizens. It can at most arrest you people. And you will say, I have to place the order. But to verify there was a crime, the government has to match this with this. This is unmatchable. Because this is a foreign country. Government of India has no jurisdiction over. And why would Mauritius give its company people to you? No company does that. Ab maan le kal India mein aisa ho. There is an Indian company behaving the same way. Would India give its own people to that country for investigation? Koi nahi deta. Iske liye some agreements are being proposed, jo aap kar lena. Anyway, mechanism clear hai? Online people clear the second mechanism? Last aur dekh lete hain, DTT. The next is known as double taxation avoidance agreement. Let's see this in this transaction itself. How this DTAA works. Same transaction. DTAA is signed between two countries or multiple countries. Name is Double Taxation Avoidance Agreement. Because when I make this transaction, it can be taxed twice. It will be taxed here and it will be taxed here also. So there will be two taxes on this transaction, number one and number two. So to avoid double transaction on same economic activity, often countries sign within themselves known as Double Taxation Avoidance Agreement. Under this, either they will tax, matlab either Mauritius will tax or India will tax. Donam se ek hi karega. Often what happen, India is unable to tax and Mauritius does not impose taxes. So the company will say, I am paying taxes to Mauritius, so I will not pay taxes to you under double taxation avoidance agreement. Genuine argument. And Mauritius mein they pay only 0.5. This is a third mechanism. Okay, so these are some mechanisms used in money laundering largely. Anyway, clear to everyone, online people, koi question ho to please ask. Chalo, phir jaldi se let us look at. So Mr. Kejriwal is blamed basically for hawala transaction that he carried out. Last mechanism. Okay, dobara dekh lete hain. There are numerous mechanisms. So, मैंने तो सिर्फ तीन बताए. These are the most popular. और भी बहुत तरीके हैं. So, DTA, Double Taxation Avoidance Agreement. Under this agreement, two countries or multiple countries sign this agreement to make sure that same economic activity is not taxed twice. जैसे for example, you go to a market, you buy a pen. So, you are taxed only once. Government of India imposed GST only one time when you buy. ऐसा थोड़ी ना है कि गवर्नमेंट विल टैक्स यू एज वेल एज द मर्चेंट. हैव यू एवर सीन जीएसटी 1, जीएसटी 2? देयर इज ओनली सिंगल जीएसटी. वन पर्सन पेस टैक्सेस फॉर वन ट्रांजैक्शन. डबल टैक्सेशन इज नॉट इम्पोज्ड. बट व्हेन टू कंट्रीज आर इन्वॉल्व्ड, देयर मे बी अ चांसेस दैट से फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई टैक्स दिस कंपनी एंड फ्रॉम रिमेनिंग लेजिटिमेट मनी आफ्टर टैक्सेस द मनी इज लेफ्ट. From that money, it places an order here. Why? It has already paid me taxes. And then same transaction will be paid here also because it is the income of this company. To avoid this, we sign this agreement. In this, any economic transaction will be taxed only at one place. Either in this country or this country. Often companies misuse this. They pay zero tax in the high tax country saying that I am already paying tax in other country and that other country often do not impose taxes. यही ब्लेम होता है अमेरिकन कंपनीज पे, एप्पल, फेसबुक, गूगल. दे व्हाट दे डू, दे डू दिस, सॉरी TTS, DTA is a treaty between the governments, for transaction that cover all transaction, including the PSU's transaction, which is now not a government body anyway. चलिए anyway. Now is it clear the third mechanism? चलिए fine, if it is clear, तो जल्दी से move करते हैं. Now let us quickly see. So all the transaction are mentioned, all the mechanism are mentioned here. Just go through it once. Now let's see what is the legal framework for dealing with money laundering. Simple hai. You have Income Tax Act. Under Income Tax Act, every financial institution has to inform IT department. IT department investigate crimes. You have Conservation of Foreign Exchange and Prevention of Smuggling Activities Act, 1974. It allows confiscation of any smuggling activity. But ek cheez hamesha yaad rakhiyega. ये जमाने जा चुके हैं. जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ यू गो इन टू अ बैंक ऑन अ गन पॉइंट, जैसे मूवियों में दिखाते हैं, यू गो टू अ बैंक ऑन अ गन पॉइंट एंड लूट द बैंक, कोई फायदा नहीं होगा. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू लूट अ बैंक, लूट लाइक विजय माल्या, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल हाइस्ट, मैंने आपको समझाया. इफ यू विल गो टू अ बैंक विद अ गन पॉइंट एंड से आई विल लूट द बैंक, सारा पैसा मेरा, कुछ नहीं होने वाला. इससे बढ़िया तो फॉर्म अ कंपनी, मेक अ कंपनी डू ट्रांजेक्शंस इन इकोनॉमिक सेंस, move money from here to there, and literally government will give you fund also, and you are unable to pay, the government will waive off your loan, known as write off. So, ye smuggling, chote logo ka kaam hai. Bade log kya karte hain? Constitutional heist. Theek hai? There are numerous mechanism for that. Anyway, smuggling, mein jo money hota hai, that money can be covered. So smuggling, money laundering through smuggling is covered here. In from taxation is covered here. Benami Transaction Prohibition Act. Benami transaction means, as the name itself implies, without name. Benami. It means without name. It means I paid for something and you bought it. Just say every husband suffer from this. They make a payment for the gift that the wife gets. So it's a Benami transaction. Because the recipient of the gift is different from the paid person. Ab ye to mazak hua. Real life mein how it works. It works in property. I will pay for the property price in cash, but it will be registered in your name. That is called Benami transaction, because that cash transaction has no name. So any transaction that government feel is Benami, that property can be seized by the government under the Benami Transaction Prohibition Act. Benami samajh mein aaya? Benami transaction is any transaction in which a product is received by somebody else and paid by somebody else from no known mechanism. No known mechanism. And property mein Benami transaction is most common. Generally, majority of the money, if you have bought a flat, where at, you say, Delhi mein bhi, kahin bhi chale jao. The big, main aapko bataya ek tarika to ho gaya, customs. If you want to become super rich by illegitimate money without anyone blaming you. Second is property. The assistant registrar of property, that person has a fixed cut. Chahe Delhi mein ho, kahin bhi ho. It's a fixed 1-2% of entire property price. It's fixed, you must pay. If you have gone, if you have not, then ask your parents. Have they paid any amount for registry? Pay karna hi padta hai. Reason being, India mein land titles are not clear. And because of this, if that person raises a single question, your property transfer cannot happen. India mein sabse zyada paisa khaya jata hai property transfer mein. Ye kya ho gaya? Anyway, so clear, Benami transactions ko clear hai, in which paid by somebody else. Next, Foreign Exchange Management Act. Under Foreign Exchange Management Act, all the transactions related to foreign exchange, dollars to rupees to rupees to dollar, whatever, is being done here. And it allows the RBI and other body to check for illegitimate flow of money. NIA Act, National Investigation Agency, any money laundering related to terrorism is covered in NIA. So all these law cover money laundering, but for different purposes. For Benami property, it is in the Benami transaction. For exchange, for exchange of rupee, it is in the FEMA. And for terrorism, it is under NIA Act. So every act deals with money laundering, but in different manner. One law clearly deals with money laundering. That known as PAMLA. This is a special law dedicated exclusively to money laundering, known as Prevention of Money Laundering Act. These are the body you can see. I told you ED. ED has powers under PAMLA. It is a law enforcement. It is the enforcement body of PAMLA, Prevention of Money Laundering Act, and ye wala, Fugitive Economic Offenders Act. Fugitive Economic Offender. Any person against whom the court issue a summon and that person do not come to the court to reply. This is Vijay Mallya. Vijay Mallya was the first person to be declared Fugitive Economic Offenders under Fugitive Economic Offenders Act. Ek bar, once you are declared as a Fugitive Economic Offenders, all your property or everything that has even a remote name of yours will be seized by the government. Everything will be seized. That is Fugitive Economic Offenders Act. The ED basically enforced both. Remember, ED is the executive body of Fugitive Economic Offenders Act and Prevention of Money Laundering Act. NIA मैंने आपको बता ही दिया. Generally, NIA investigate terror crimes. But if there is a money angle, then it may investigate. It may take help from ED also. Another is combating financing of terrorism cell. It's a specialized body within the law enforcement bodies, basically. ज्यादातर आपकी पुलिस वगैरह जो होती है, they have a special financial crime cell. तो पुलिस आपका सीबीआई वगैरह, they have a financial crime cell in them. If there is a bigger crime, then they transfer the case to ED. If it is in the PAMLA, otherwise they investigate. Next is financial, मैंने आपको बताई दिया. Financial intelligence unit under PAMLA, all intermediary organization must report to आपका financial intelligence unit. It vets the transaction. If it finds it has some problem or something, then it recommend that transaction to ED to investigate. International cooperation, these are some convention, Vienna Convention, known as United Nations Convention against illegal traffic in narcotics, drug and psychotropic substance, simply drugs convention. और एक चीज हमेशा याद रखी है, these are organized crime. Remember, wherever you have drugs, guns and prostitute, you have illegitimate money. Without that, how would you facilitate these transactions? Guns, drugs and prostitute, they are facilitated by, obviously baat hai, you have gone to take a prostitute, to aap use check se to pay nahi karoge. So wahan pe legitimate money is generally used. But problem wahi aati hai that I've told you, everyone is involved. Everyone se mera matlab ye nahi ki everyone is corrupt. They are good people also. Everyone se, I mean everyone at different levels. ऐसा नहीं है, these are the common people doing this crime. पैसा ही नहीं है खाने का, ये क्या करेंगे? They facilitate these crimes. The consumer of these crimes are the rich people. This is the world largest consumer of drug. कौन है? United States of America. USA is the world largest consumer of drug. World largest producer of drugs. Afghanistan, Pakistan. Pak region is called as Golden Crescent. And Southeast Asian country, Myanmar वगैरह, known as Golden Triangle. So the largest producer are developing countries. The largest consumer is a developed countries. Money. So there's a perception among the people that drugs, guns, prostitute, these are basically for the bad, poor people. Nahi. They provide. The consumption is always exclusively by the rich, the powerful, the connected. The USA to aise bhi blame hai. USA is very famous. The world largest, the world richest country is famous for children known as pedophile. Pedophile ka matlab hota hai person having sex with a child. Pedophile. Pedophile or pedophilia. Pedophile USA is the largest consumer of pedophile pawns and pedophilic people. Why? Paisa hai. Well, with money comes ability to satisfy desires. And they are the largest consumer. And who is the largest producer? Of course, developing countries. So this is the problem. The consumer of these services are the rich and elite. These people have power and they are connected. Isliye aapko maine hamesha samjhaya, these crimes can never be stopped. Drugs, alcohol, money laundering, prostitution. Kabhi aap nahi rok paoge, aap apni puri jindagi laga do. Kyon nahi rok paoge? Because demand hai. And I told you, whenever there is a demand, there will always be a supply. जब तक सप्लाई डिमांड है सप्लाई रहेगी रहेगी. जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल बिहार इज अ ड्राई स्टेट बट अल्कोहल इज स्टिल अवेलेबल. बट इफ आई हैव टू ड्रिंक आई विल ड्रिंक. सरकार रोक नहीं सकती मुझे. If the government will make it illegal, I will buy from black marketing. And that is more lucrative. I will give you a bottle of beer for 150 rupees if it is legal. I will give you for 500 rupees if it is illegal. So where I have bigger margin? Illegal. And illegal, everyone earns. The police wala will have a cut. The local bureaucrat will have a cut. The DM will have a cut. The Neta will have a cut. So this is the reason these crimes never stop. And I can guarantee you on any stamp paper, these crimes will never stop anyway. Aap at most, fir aap kya kar sakte hain? Kuch nahi kar sakte hain, bas try to do something about it. Kisi tarah rokne ki koshish hi kar paoge. Because if you arrest somebody, aapne dekha hoga, har din news aati hai, that in this spa center, there was a raid. People were, jaisa kal in, I think, Noida or Gurgaon, large number of spas were raided and large number of women and boys were arrested by the police. Kal ya parso ki news hai. Of course, spa center में सबको पता है क्या चलता है, but I can guarantee ये दो दिन के ड्रामा है, कल परसों फिर वो चलने लग जाएंगे. The reason being demand. मैं फिर कह रहा हूँ, demand है. As long as people will demand something, somebody will provide something. You cannot stop this demand. If you want to kill a crime, kill the demand. If you kill the demand for drugs, would I manufacture drugs if nobody will consume it? Am I a stupid person? I will produce something else. इसीलिए demand बनाए रखते हैं. और कैसे बनाते हैं? There are a lot of resources. So civil, social media, movies. उन्हें दिखाते हैं ना, मस्त गांजा पियो, मजे में घूमो. FATF. It is the only body at the final world level, main body, that aims to tackle, कहाँ गया? Money laundering, terrorism financing and pollution financing. तो money, organized crime से world level पे कौन deal करता है? FATF. India के level पे? Enforcement Directorate. There are other two groups, देख लेना, Egmont Group भी है और ये भी है. So we have seen the laws regarding money laundering and other crimes. We have seen the institutions. Let's see the law and why it is being disputed. वो भी समझेंगे. It basically aims to curb the money laundering. It allows the ED to confiscate property and it also allow to deal with any other money laundering issue. अब dispute redressal कैसे होता है? There is an adjudicating authority appointed by the central government to decide on attachment of property and seizure. Let's say a bank reported to financial intelligence unit something fishy is going on. FIU will investigate because it is an intelligence unit. It is like you can say spy agency of finances. So it will investigate. If it finds something wrong is there, it will refer that to ED, Enforcement Directorate. You can also complain to Enforcement Directorate. So ED starts the process. ED starts investigation. After that, if ED want to confiscate your property, take you to the jail, jo bhi drama hote hain, that all is done by Enforcement Directorate. Let's say ED want to attach your property, says that your property is because of money laundering. So for that, it has to go to adjudicating authority. It is largely known as Pamela courts. For this purpose, government has made court. This is Ross Avenue. Delhi mein jo Ross Avenue hai, wahan pe you have a court, Pamela court, prevention of money laundering court. This court exclusively deals with Pamela cases. Aur koi case se deal nahi karta hai. So Pamela court mein ED will go and say, I think that these properties, these things, are proceeds of money laundering. I want to attach them. Attach ka matlab hota hai, confiscate them, keep them, seize them. If you have a problem, then of course you can go to appellate tribunal. If that order does not come in your favor, you can go to high court, then you can go to Supreme Court. So this is the legal mechanism. Same is for investigation. So process sabko samajh mein aaya, what is the process? A bank, a financial, any financial institution, or even complained by politics, in this case, the investigation started basically on a complaint by Congress. In 2017-18, Congress made a complaint. In 2019, Congress made a complaint to ED that there is a scam in the liquor policy. Because this time Congress was not with आम आदमी पार्टी इन एन अलायंस. कांग्रेस ने तो कंप्लेंट की थी, बीजेपी को तो बस बीजेपी बस वेटिंग कि कोई तो आए. एंड अल्टीमेटली ईडी स्टार्ट्स. ठीक है, नेक्स्ट. मैंने आपको बताई दिया, देयर स्पेशल कोर्ट्स नोन एज पैमला कोर्ट्स. And this is what you have all institution, banking companies, financial institution, intermediaries. They must maintain, verify all the records and provide information to FIU. And this provision is, these two provisions are the problem. Why Arvind Kejriwal did not get the bail yesterday? Why he could not get the bail? Because Pamela mein bail milta hi nahi hai. This law was made to deal with money laundering. And I told you, proving the traces of money laundering is virtually impossible. Bahut mushkil hota hai. Until unless there is a lot of investigation and lot of efforts and lot of luck of the investigation agency. Pata nahi lagta economic crimes ka. Bahut mushkil hai pata lagana. In that scenario, these provisions are the reason that Kejriwal will never get the bail. Because the reason is, this law is reversed. All the criminal laws of India believes, remember, Pamela is a criminal law. Criminal law means in which jail term is compulsory, fine is optional. Civil law mein fine is compulsory, jail term is optional. So, under every criminal law in India, it is assumed you are innocent until proven guilty. In every criminal law, it is assumed. So, who has to prove you guilty? The investigating agency. In every law mein, it is assumed that you are innocent until proven guilty. So, the investigating agency, ED, CBI, jo bhi hai, they have to prove that you are guilty. You don't have to prove. They have to prove. This law is reversed. This law mein, the person who is accused, he has to prove I am innocent. This is the reason that ED can arrest you. Samajh mein aaya, what is the problem? In legal terms, we call this mens rea. Mens rea means guilty intent. Mens rea or guilty intent. So this is a very special law. If you are blamed under Pamela, then agencies do not have to prove you are guilty. You have to prove you are innocent. So the burden of proof is lies with you. Baaki case mein kya hota hai? The agency proves. They provide document by this person is guilty. Court will assume you are not guilty. Then the agency will prove you are guilty. In this, ulta is there. It is reversed. The court will assume you are guilty. And then you have to prove I am not. That's why it is a very severe case. Another thing. This is a very big drama. Any statement given in front of investigation officer of ED is admissible in court. It's a clear violation of Article 22. Of the Constitution. Article 22 of the Constitution, known as protection with respect to conviction of an, sorry, 20, 22 keh raha hu main, 20, Article 20, protection with respect to conviction of an offense. Under Article 20, any statement given in front of a police officer is not binding or is not verifiable in court of law. Yahan pe ulta hai. If you give a statement, kyun kara gaya tha ise? Isme nahi, previous mein. Because we had experience with the British Empire. Oh, bahut asaan hai. I will take you into the jail. Police will beat you. Police will beat the shit out of you and ultimately will make you sign anything. Or out of the fear of beating. Chahe wo peete bhi na. They will scare you so much because understand, there are 6 to 7 police officers with weapons and you are armless. So in that scenario, this police officer even threaten and creates the atmosphere. So you will be scared. And generally people sign anything to prevent torture. Isliye under Article 20. And Britishers used this. Britishers used to beat Indian nationals. Indian freedom fighters. They were beaten into the police station. And they were made to sign anything under the sun. So we evolved this principle. It is a common sense. It is a part of principle of natural justice. That a statement given in front of a investigating officer is not admissible. Yahan pe kya hai? Admissible. So these two provisions are bigger. And that's why Arvind Kejriwal is likely to not get the bail. Because pehla point, he has to prove I am innocent. ED does not have to prove he is not. Second, ED can frame him on the basis of only statements. Abhi clear to hum pe hai nahin. We do not know the real picture because all the documents are not revealed. But ED can also insinuate. Just for example, I arrest your friend. I found him stealing something. I say, for example, he was doing money laundering, I arrested him. I hate you very much. So what I will do, I will pressurize him for any reason. Marunga pitunga nahi, because usme dikh jata hai. I have to produce you into a court and court verify the physical assault. I will do other kind of assault. I will threaten your family or relative, jo bhi padta hai. And then I will make you to give a statement to me that your friend will give a statement to me that you are also part of the crime. And it is admissible in the court of law. Then I will arrest you on the grounds that I believe you are accused. Then you have to prove it to the court I am not. Ye blame kar rahi hai Aam Aadmi Party Kejriwal case mein. See what happened? ED arrested that... I'm forgetting her name. She was arrested a few weeks back by ED from South. Kuch naam dhyan nahi raha us ladki ka mujhe. She is the daughter of the chief minister, former chief minister. She was arrested. It has been accused by the Aam Aadmi Party. She was arrested. She gave a statement. And under Pamela, it's an admissible document. Based on that investigation, that statement by that person and a lot of people, including some MLA from Goa. Ha, K. Kavita, yes. K. Kavita was arrested. She gave a statement saying that Arvind Kejriwal is a linchpin. He was the main person and there were some MLAs from Goa. So all these are statements. Based on which ED says, I believe Arvind Kejriwal has committed the offense and arrested Arvind Kejriwal. Clear? We don't know what are the documents, but understand. इसमें क्राइम मैं फिर बोल रहा हूँ प्रूविंग अ मॉनेटरी ऑफेंस इज वर्चुअली इम्पॉसिबल इट्स अ सीवियर केस बाकी एंड तो ये पॉइंट तो क्लियर है दिस पॉइंट क्लियरली वॉलेट्स आर्टिकल 20 बट नॉनदलेस लीगली वैलिड नाउ तो दीज टू पॉइंट्स आर वेरी हार्ड इट इज अज्यूम्ड यू आर गिल्टी यू हैव टू प्रूव इनोसेंट सेकंड एवरी स्टेटमेंट इन फ्रंट ऑफ आईओ इज एडमिसिबल उसके बाद मोदी गवर्नमेंट ब्रॉट एन अमेंडमेंट व्हाई टेकिंग बेल इज वर्चुअली इम्पॉसिबल इन पैमला Reason being that to give a bail, court pe do condition hai. Pehla, the court has to believe that the accused is not guilty. Matlab, once you are arrested by ED, the first under Pamela, it will be assumed you are guilty. Then you have to prove I am not guilty. And after that, bail will be given. Baat samajh mein aaya? This law is very strict. Normal case mein kya hota hai? You go to a police arrest you go to a court. And court assumes you are non-guilty, then police has to prove you are guilty. And even if there is a reasonable doubt if that police's version is wrong, bail is given. इसलिए normal crime bail is easily given. यहाँ पे उल्टा है. यहाँ पे once you are arrested, the court will assume you are guilty. Then you have to prove I am not guilty. And only when you can prove it beyond doubt, क्योंकि इसमें देखिए साफ लिखा है. The court has to believe this. So you have to prove this beyond doubt that you are not guilty. Then only bail can be given. And that's why Kejriwal will never get the bail. Yeah, clear? Hai? So this provision was added in 2018. That's why Pamela is very strict. Anyway, baaki aap padh lena. ED ka maine isme batai diya hai. Please read that. Online people, clear everyone? Any question? So we have discussed money laundering and we have discussed a very important law of money laundering known as PAMELA. Next, Global Happiness Index. So it has been published 2024. In this, Finland remains the happiest country in the world. I told you Nordic countries are always the happiest. These countries, Norway, Finland, Sweden, these are known as Nordic countries. They are on the near North Pole. And these countries are always in the top of every indicator. You pick democracy index, you pick human rights index, you pick any index on earth. And in that indicator, they are always on the top. Reason I told you in numerous classes, because they are in top of press freedom index. They are in among the top. And this is a correlation. Any country which is in the tops of press freedom index automatically is in top of democracy index. And of course, when you have a functional, beautiful democracy, all other indicator automatically increases. This is the link. Any country which is high on the press freedom, because what is the role of the press? The role of the press is to talk for the people against the government. they are the keeper. They are the IDs of the people in democracies. So whichever country is in top in press freedom is automatically top in democracy index and is in top in every indicator. And that's why these countries, they're always in top because they are top in press freedom. The press of these countries make sure that government remains accountable to people every second of their life. Unlike Indian media, but baki sab theek hai. So let's see who created this. So it has been published, sponsored by United Nations. Let's see the findings. The top 10 happiest country, dekh lijiye sari ki sari, Denmark, Iceland, Sweden, Israel, Netherlands, Norway, Luxembourg. Itna yaad mat rakhna, just remember Finland is the top. Or you can wild guess any Nordic country ka naam likh dena. Denmark wagera. Denmark, Iceland, Finland, Sweden. They are always in top in every indicator. So without thinking, aap unka naam likh sakte ho. These are among the topest country. That's it. India has 126th rank in 143. So we are not very happy. The unhappiest country on earth is right now Afghanistan. And for the first time, even US and Germany are not the happy countries. They are on the 23rd and 24th. Par humse to bahut hi badhiya hai. China bhi humse badhiya hai 16th pe. Nepal bhi humse badhiya hai. Pakistan bhi humse badhiya hai yaar. Myanmar bhi badhiya hai. Who is behind us? Behind us is Sri Lanka and Bangladesh. So Sri Lanka and Bangladesh are behind this. Of course, government of India criticized this index as an intentional attempt to malign the image. But nonetheless, understand happiness. कई लोग क्वेश्चन करते हैं अ कंट्री कॉल्ड पाकिस्तान विच वर्चुअली सफर फ्रॉम बैंक्रप्सी हैज हैप्पीनेस मोर हैप्पीनेस एंड अ कंट्री कॉल्ड इंडिया विच इज बेटर देन पाकिस्तान डज नॉट हैव हैप्पीनेस अंडरस्टैंड वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट हैप्पीनेस नॉट ग्रोथ वी आर नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट जीडीपी वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट हैप्पीनेस जस्ट बिकॉज यू हैव मनी डजंट मीन यू आर हैप्पी वेरी गुड एग्जाम्पल ये इसमें मैं आपको बता देता हूँ Who published this? It is published by, please remember this name, Pilgrims Fund directly can be asked. Sustainable Development Solution Network. It's a body within United Nations along with Oxford University Research Center. So they jointly published this. And what I was telling, it was an initiative of Bhutan. Bhutan is the only country in the world that calculate gross national happiness. Bhutan does not calculate GDP. Gross domestic product, as we calculate. Bhutan's calculate gross national happiness. The premier of Bhutan, the king of Bhutan, he was on a vibrant Gujarat summit. It's a summit organized by Gujarat government, invited various people. He said a very beautiful line there. They were all the industrialists of India sitting in the front row. You know those people. So he said, out of a joke, he said that some of you people has more wealth than the combined GDP of my entire country. Sahi baat bhi hai, Bhutan bahut chota sa hai. Reliance is bigger than Bhutan. Some of you people have more wealth than entire GDP of my country. But nonetheless, we are more happier. That was a good remark. Basic logic is Bhutan does not care about growth. It cares about happiness of the people. And these are two parameters. That's why you face the situation. India is the fifth largest economy in the world. Around $4 trillion. With highest poverty, malnutrition, hunger, disease, and unemployment. Dono alag hai. Growth, development alag hota hai. Same happiness and growth are different parameters. So these are the parameters. GDP per capita is one parameter. Social support, India mein aapko pata hi hai, zero hai. India mein we have a thinking known as char log. India mein we do not inspire you to do something. We inspire you to conform. The social norms. India does not have individualistic living. We have a collective living. So rather than promoting you to live by your standard, we promote you to live by society's standard, known as communal living. So freedom to choose a choice in one's life. Aapko pata ye halat kya hai. Healthy life expectancy and life expectancy rate, which is a bit good in India. Perception of corruption and kindness. So look at these parameters. These are very qualitative parameters about your how much you feel you're free to make choices about your life, how much kindness you feel in the society, the people, the government. What is the perception of corruption? Again, perception of corruption has nothing to do with corruption. you believe there is a corruption, whether it is not on, whether it is there or not is different parameter. So please remember, these are the parameter, this is the indicator. India has been not doing very well. बाकी मैंने आपको समझा ही दिया. भूटान कैलकुलेट जीएनपी, सॉरी ग्रॉस नेशनल हैप्पीनेस, नॉट रिमेंबर हु पब्लिश दिस, बस इतना ही है इसमें. जेंडर इनइक्वालिटी इंडेक्स, इसको भी जल्दी से देख लेते हैं. जीआईआई, रिमेंबर हु पब्लिश दिस, इट इज पब्लिश बाय यूएनडीपी, यूनाइटेड नेशन डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम पब्लिश आपका जेंडर इनइक्वालिटी इंडेक्स एज अ पार्ट ऑफ ह्यूमन डेवलपमेंट रिपोर्ट. अब अंडर दिस रिपोर्ट द रीसेंट रैंकिंग, इंडिया इज रैंक दिस 108th आउट ऑफ 193 कंट्री, मींस इट हैज इंप्रूव्ड. तो देयर इज अ इंप्रूवमेंट ऑफ 14 रैंक्स, मतलब जेंडर पैरिटी वी आर इंप्रूविंग. और ये विजिबल भी है, इफ यू सी एनी गवर्नमेंट एग्जाम नाउ गवर्नमेंट एड्स अ लाइन देयर, गवर्नमेंट इनकरेजेस वुमन टू अप्लाई. तो ये तो कॉमन सेंस है, अराउंड द वर्ल्ड वुमन इक्वालिटी इज इंक्रीजिंग. Recent report hai that previous year the woman rate of hiring has increased to around 40%. Means the chances that you will be hired as a woman private sector mein has increased. Kyunki maine aapko bataya tha hiring a woman is a difficult task. Male ko hire karna aasan hota hai. You give them any salary, you can make them work any hours, you can call them at odd hours, you can bring them at odd hours. Woman ko employment dena thoda mushkil kaam hota hai. If you give them a employment, you have to deal with a lot of parameters. First, ensure her safety in the office as well as out of the office. She has to be dropped by you if there is late hours. There's a BPO. All the BPO who works in the night drops and picks the woman from their home. So that is added expenditure. Male ho to mujhe tension nahi khuda. That plus security both at office and outside office. As long as you are out of your home and you have come to my office, you are my responsibility. Plus other dramas, I cannot call you at odd hours. So, इसलिए क्या होता है, generally women are not preferred very much by companies to hire. इसलिए नहीं, they lack talent. इसलिए the societal conditions are very high. ऊपर से law इतने dramadar हैं कि you cannot call a woman to office after 8 or 9, ऐसे भी law हैं. तो conditions are high and I don't want drama. I want work. I want a person who can work for me, not give me headache. इसलिए often women are not hired. But nonetheless, it's a good news that जेंडर इनइक्वालिटी इंडेक्स में इंडिया रैंक हैज इंप्रूव, मतलब वुमन नाउ एंजॉय बेटर इक्वालिटी देन अर्लियर. बट फिर भी अच्छा नहीं है, 108 तो बहुत ही बेकार है. वी शुड बी एटलीस्ट इन 50s. इंडिया इज अ डेमोक्रेसी, डेमोक्रेसी में एटलीस्ट 50s में तो हम. एंड द प्राइम रीजन इज आपको पता है, पेट्रियार्की है, नॉट इम्पोज बाय मैन, इम्पोज बाय वुमन ऑन देमसेल्फ. इट इज नॉट द मैन हु आर इम्पोजिंग दिस, इट इज द वुमन इम्पोजिंग ऑन देमसेल्फ, पर्टिकुलरली द एल्डरलीज. सो लेट अस सी about gender inequality index. There are 3 major areas, please remember all of them: reproductive health, empowerment and labor market. Jaldi se dekhte hain reproductive health. According to United Nations Development Program data, reproductive health accounts for largest loss due to gender inequality among all regions. What is its reproductive health? There are two dimensions within this. Pehla, maternal mortality ratio, means the mother who dies while giving birth or immediately after giving birth. If a country has high maternal mortality, it means that the women have less preference to medical services than the men. So high maternal mortality matlab less availability of medical services to women, it means it clearly shows their second class citizen status. So it's a parameter here. Second, adolescent fertility rate. If a woman is getting pregnant and giving birth at earlier ages, the younger a woman give birth or get pregnant, the lesser are the chances they will receive education and proper upbringing. In India case mein, there is a bigger problem of child marriage. India mein abhi bhi large number of women are married before 18. 14 ke baad, but before 18 they are largely married. We have discussed this in current affairs earlier. That was an eye-opening report for me also. So if a country has high adolescent matlab the people in their teenagers, if there is high adolescent fertility, iska matlab the young girls are bearing children at early age, it means it's a health crisis as well as a educational crisis. So first dimension is reproductive health. There are two parts in this: maternal mortality ratio and adolescent fertility. Next, empowerment. the share of parliamentary seats held by each sex. Ab dekhiye why we are having this. Out of all the dimensions, सबसे important यही है. Not in the indicator, वहां तो equal weightage है. But real life में I have told you multiple times, without political power, nothing happens. If you want to bring a change that you desire, you must be politically powerful. And we have discussed this, I don't know कब करा था, but we discussed this exclusively in current affairs regarding the amendment to the constitution in which now the women have 33% reservation. उसमें मैंने detail में discuss किया था, you can take the previous classes देख लेना एक बार. वहां पर आई टोल्ड यू दैट वुमन पार्टिसिपेशन इन पॉलिटिक्स हैज थ्री डायमेंशंस, एज अ वोटर, एज अ कैंडिडेट एंड एज अ इलेक्टेड ऑफिशियल. मतलब एमपी, एमएलए, सीएम, पीएम, द थ्री डायमेंशन. वुमन एज अ वोटर, अकॉर्डिंग टू, यू कैन चेक बैक द क्लास, इन दैट क्लास वी अंडरस्टूड 80% ऑफ द वुमन रिपोर्टेड इन 2019 टू डिसाइड टू वोट अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर डिजायर्स. इट्स हायर फ्रॉम 40%. 2014 में 40% of the women said they voted the person they wanted. Lastly, क्या होता है? Women in the household, they vote the person their family wants. जिसने husband ने जिसे वोट दिया, पापा ने जिसे वोट दिया, उनको दे दिया वोट. So it's a good parameters. Amendment मुझे याद नहीं है, 106th है या 8th है, चेक कर लेना एक बार. Amendment मुझे याद नहीं आ रही. But remember this we have discussed. So as a voting, woman participation is increased now. Now, women in India vote equal to men. There is very narrow difference. So I think 0.3 or 0.2. Negligible. So women in India vote equal to men. In rural area, mein, women vote more than men. Some areas, mein, women vote more than men. Other areas, mein, overall, India, mein, voting percentage of men and women is virtually equal. So as a voter, women are very sensible now. But the problem is, as a candidate and as a elected official, woman presence is virtually absent. Not more than 20% of all the candidates were women. And right now in parliament, you have the highest membership, 14%. Since independence, right now in parliament, you have the highest woman MPs, 14%. This is the problem, this is the parameter. Bhai, agar aap parliament mein nahi ho, if you're not in the parliament, then how would you make laws for you? You will have males making law for you according to their desires, their understanding of what women want. This is the biggest weakness in the woman movement I've highlighted multiple times. That's why it's a very important parameter. More the seats, more the power. And without political power, no change come. Next, higher education attainment level. Basically, simple sa logic, more the education, more the freedom of choice. More the education, more the freedom of choice. But remember a myth that I told you earlier also. There's a general myth that with increased education, there is increased woman participation in economics. Matlab economic activity. Aisa nahi hota hai, I told you pehle bhi. It's a known fact. As the woman education increases, their participation in working force decreases. Second, as the family income increases. हमें क्या लगता है that generally in rich family women have more choices, they can work outside. Myth है. It's a common known fact, if a family can provide for the woman child or wife or whatever, they will not prefer her to work outside. As family income increases, the chances that the woman have to work outside decreases rapidly. So high family income में women often do not work outside. जबकि लो इनकम फैमिली दे डू, पर्टिकुलरली इन द लोएस्ट इनकम. इफ यू हैव गॉन टू दिल्ली में आपने देखा होगा इन द फुटपाथ, यू विल सी देयर इज अ मेल वर्किंग ऑन द फुटपाथ, सेम फीमेल भी वही काम कर रही होती है, उनका बच्चा भी वही खेल रहा होता है, बिकॉज दे कैन नॉट अफोर्ड. अगर वो महिला काम नहीं करेगी तो खाना कैसे खाएंगे. द मेल वर्क्स देयर, द फीमेल वर्क्स देयर, इवन द स्मॉल किड्स प्ले देयर, दे कुक द फूड एट द सेम साइट एंड ईट. In lower classes, woman participation in economy is better, and understand, woman empowerment is high in low income families than high income families, because they have money, they don't make the woman work outside, they don't have it, and most important, they don't want their woman to go into politics. It's the least preferred option, but within women themselves, क्योंकि क्या होता है, बचपन से सिखाया गया होता है बच्चों को, खासकर लड़कों को, दैट यू हैव नो ऑप्शन बट टू वर्क आउटसाइड. जैसे आपको बोला जाता है ना, देख लड़कियों के इसमें एक ऑप्शन है उनके पास, काम नहीं भी करेंगी तो घर पे काम कर सकती है. लड़कों के केस में ये ऑप्शन नहीं है. अ बॉय डज नॉट हैव द लग्जरी टू वर्क एट होम. अगर घर पे काम करेगा तो बेइज्जती होगी, घर जमाई निकम्मा बीवी के टुकड़ों पे पलता है, ऑल दिस स्लोगन्स विल कम, मैनहुड विल बी हर्ट बेसिकली. सो द नैरेटिव ऑफ द सोसाइटी इज द मैन हैज नो ऑप्शन बट टू वर्क आउटसाइड, एंड दैट इज वाई सुसाइड अमंग मैन इज मोर देन वुमन. बिकॉज इवन इफ वुमन इज अनेबल टू गेट एनी जॉब, शी कैन वर्क एट होम and nobody will call her unproductive asset. But if a man is unable to get a job, then the society is very ruthless. Very, very ruthless. No, not, aisa koi provision nahi hai Gaurav. Constitution does not forbid anyone from working from anywhere. But it is practically not feasible. A chief minister has to take a lot of meetings, a lot of consultation. Isme kya hoga, if you are working from jail, then your chief secretary, your DGP, all have to come to the jail. And uske liye every time they require permit from the court. Kitni baar court permit dega? Court pe yehi kaam bacha hai ki tumhe permit deta rahega. It's not practically feasible. Constitution does not prohibit this. Anyway, clear hai sabko? So remember, in gender inequality index, empowerment, two parameters are there. Shares in parliamentary seats and higher education attainment. Better the higher education, better the empowerment, better the shares in the seat of the parliament, better is the representation. Okay, but remember this fact also, as the family income increases, the woman participation in workforce decreases. Plus, as the education increases, the woman participation in workforce also decreases. First reason, they remain out of workforce. If you are not very literate, you start working early. Otherwise, you remain unemployed for 30, 20, jo bhi hai. Because for a longer time, you spend time in education, you do masters, you do PhD, you're out of workforce for a longer time. Plus, when you have high qualification, with high qualification comes high desires. I will not do this job. Then you have a preference for a job. For example, you are seventh fail. In that case, you just want money. You won't care what kind of job. But if you are graduate, for example, you are IIT graduate, then you have aura. Isse niche kaam nahi karunga main. और हर बार वो जॉब नहीं मिलता है, इसलिए भी वो अनएम्प्लॉयड रहते. तो दो रीजन समझ में आए, फर्स्ट द मोर यू स्टडी द मोर यू आर आउट ऑफ वर्कफोर्स, सेकंड द मोर यू स्टडी द मोर द प्रेफरेंस ऑफ जॉब्स कम्स इन, सो यू बिकम सिलेक्टिव एंड इकोनॉमी कैन नॉट प्रोवाइड जॉब अकॉर्डिंग टू योर डिजायर. ठीक है, क्लियर है, दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम, तो प्लीज रिमेंबर दैट. लास्ट पॉइंट देख लेते हैं, लेबर मार्केट पार्टिसिपेशन. Basically, paid work, unpaid work, activities, actively looking for work, providing gender disparity in economic participation. So, three parameter clear hai. The parameter one, aapka kya tha? Reproductive health. Parameter one, reproductive health. Within that, you have two parameter, maternal mortality ratio and adolescent fertility rate. Empowerment, shares in parliament and higher education. And last is labor market participation. Based on that, GII is prepared by UNDP. It ranges from 0 to 1. 0 means absolute equality. 1 means absolute inequality. And, aise hi hai. Ye toh maine aapko samjhai diya. Sexual violence, female feticide, wagera wagera, the woman have to be here. And for this, वैसे इसमें है नहीं, मैं reference के लिए बता देता हूँ. These are the initiative government of India. ये प्रॉब्लम मैंने आपको समझा दी, चाइल्ड मैरिज में जो भी ड्रामे होते हैं, चाइल्ड मैरिज, डोरी डिमांड, रेस्ट्रिक्शन मोबिलिटी, फीमेल इन्फेंटिसाइड. जैसे फीमेल इन्फेंटिसाइड, इफ आई आस्क यू टू गेस हु हैव मोर फीमेल इन्फेंटिसाइड, द रिच और द पुअर? हु कैरी आउट फीमेल इन्फेंटिसाइड मोर, द रिच और द पुअर? सही बात है. The reason is the poor often do not do female infanticide. But what is our image? The image is the poor people cannot afford a female. Because ladki paida hona bhi bahut risky, bahut mehenga kaam hota hai. A girl is born, you have to take care of her health, protect her from the people, and bahut drama hote hain. It's a costly affair. Plus, a woman born means that hanging sword of dowry. Kiske liye paisa bachana padega. Ladka hai to leke aayega tension. So social norms hai. It's hard to have a girl child. Particularly with respect to societal norms and other things. But still, in poor families, having a girl child is more blessed. than rich families. The reason being, poor families mein the girl work as equal to a male outside. Jaise farms, 60% of farm labor is woman. Man nahi hai. Because most of the men from rural areas come to urban areas. They are here rickshaw pullers, chote mote jo bhi hai. Majority of the rural men, they come into urban areas to earn extra wages. The women are left behind. The majority of the farm labor is a woman. And they work as equal as a man. So when you work as equal as a man outside, so you have equal reputation. They don't see women as a burden. Rich families mein kya hai? They don't prefer their girl working outside. So like extra kharcha aa gaya hamare upar. Theek hai? So these are the norms. Please remember, do not be classist. Theek hai, remember? Anyway, so these are the things, sexual harassment wagera padh lena. Ab initiative dekh lete hain Bharat Sarkar ke. Beti bachao, beti padhao. Basically to improve sex ratio. Save girl child and literate her. Samagra Siksha means comprehensive education. Samagra means comprehensive largely. Comprehensive education that focus especially on girl child. Stand Up India. Stand Up India is a scheme within Startup India. This is Startup India. Hai. Startup India mein government provide incentives for startups. Stand Up India mein government provide extra money to whom? To women entrepreneurs. Women who want to start their businesses, they get extra money. Reason being, women ko generally funding nahi milta hai. Social biases. Because often investors, investor often invest according to productivity. A perception ye hai, a male, if he is running a company, he will not leave a company. But there's a perception that if I invest on a woman startup, the pehla number, I have a lot of parameters to uphold. Second, what are the chances she will continue? Ho sakta hai she may get married and after that she settle down, leave the jobs. Bahut ladkiyan hain, they leave the jobs after marriage. But common sense, double kaam kaun karega? You expect them to work at home and then you expect them to work outside. Itna befu koi nahi hai. So they are like, chhodo bahar ki job. Koi ghar ka kaam chhod nahi sakte. Taane milenge ghar mein. You cannot leave a household chores because the family, even if they are highly liberal, even if they are highly modern, they still expect the woman child or the woman daughter-in-law to take care of household function. Matlab, even if you don't cook, if you have a cook, that cook ko supervise aapko hi karna hai. Even if you can afford a cook, who will supervise that cook? The girl child or the daughter-in-law. The male child or the son-in-law will not supervise the cook. So still, that is your function. In that scenario, large number of women leave jobs. And they often do not get funding for startup because people have biasness. They believe that she may not work out. Isliye government launched Stand Up India. Clear? Next. Ye bhi achha hai. Mahila e-heart. Under this, there are a lot of women entrepreneurs and self-help group who make very small products but very impactful. Like designer clothes and whatever. Bahut chota kaam hota hai unka. Lekin bahut kamal ka kaam hota. They work at a very small level but they work very beautifully on that. Uske liye government has launched Mahila e-heart. The woman can list their products and can sell directly to the people through this portal. One Stop Center, ye bahut achha hai. This was instituted after, kya tha committee ka naam? Justice Verma, yes. Justice Verma. After Nirbhaya rape case, Justice Verma committee was appointed to suggest on improvement of government efforts for women safety. One of the parameters they suggested was create One Stop Center. Why? Because Justice Verma committee said when a woman is assaulted by an outsider or insider, but usme ek cheez yaad rakhega, another myth. Majority of the women are assaulted in families. 90% of the people who try to commit rape or literally rapes a woman, they are known to the woman. Largely unknown people do not do such kind of crimes. Why? Natural psychology. This aapke case mein, you have a very good friend. You go outside, after the class, you are going outside from the street, you see your friend buying something. So you will go and give a tapli. So that is your friend. Tapli means hit him. What are you doing here without me? But would you do the same with any person? No. Because element known as fear of unknown comes. That's a natural psyche. If you know a friend and you find him doing something without you, you go and fight. But if you saw an unknown person, even if he's doing something abhorrible, you often do not fight. Because element of unknown is there. You have no idea what that man is capable of. You have idea what is your friend capable of. And that's why majority of the crimes against women are committed by known to the woman. The ex-boyfriend, the present boyfriend, some departed partner, elderlies, aapko pata hi hoga, child abuse. 50% of children in India suffer from child abuse. And who perform that? The elderly, the cha-cha, taya, maya, dada. Because you're a kid, you don't understand what is bad touch. आपको समझ में आता नहीं बैड टच क्या होता है, उनको तो समझ में आता है, बट बाय द टाइम यू ग्रो तब आपको समझ में आता है दैट एल्डरली वर टचिंग यू इन इनएप्रोप्रिएट मैनर्स, पर तब तक बहुत लेट हो चुका होता है. एंड अनदर थिंग, ऑफन फैमिलीज डू नॉट गो टू कोर्ट अगेंस्ट देयर ओन फैमिली मेंबर, दे कन्फ्रंट देम कि आज के बाद तो दिख मत जाना यहाँ पे, बट इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि दे विल गो टू, बट दे विल डोंट, दे डोंट गो टू courts, because family name बर्बाद होता है. और ऐसा ये नहीं गरीबों की बात कर रहा हूँ, you can go to rich families. Sexual abuse among children, and it's a shame. आपको सोचिए 50%, ये मेरी रिपोर्ट नहीं है, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ वुमन एंड चाइल्ड डेवलपमेंट, उसकी रिपोर्ट के मुताबिक 50% ऑफ किड्स इन इंडिया आर सेक्सुअली असोल्टेड ऑफ वेरिंग डिग्रीज. समवन हैज असोल्टेड देम सेक्सुअली, ईदर टच देम इनएप्रोप्रिएटली और हैड लिटरल इंटरकोर्सेस. And the chances that a male child is abused is higher than a girl child. Elderly is more. When you're adult mein girl child assault is more than the male child. But kids mein, the abuse of a boy child is more than the chances is the girl child. Ab, this should be the debate on national media. That's why I told you, they are not working. They are the only threat in democracy. This should be the debate. Iske baare mein sochna chahiye na unhe. इसके लिए जस्टिस वर्मा कमेटी ने क्या बोला, क्रिएट वन स्टॉप सेंटर, बिकॉज वेन एवर अ वुमन इज असॉल्टेड दे डू नॉट गो टू पुलिस स्टेशन, पुलिस की अच्छी इमेज नहीं है, दे गो टू हॉस्पिटल फॉर श्योर. वर्मा कमेटी सेड दैट इन एवरी हॉस्पिटल इन इंडिया देर मस्ट बी अ डेडिकेटेड प्लेस नोन एज वन स्टॉप सेंटर. स्टेट कैन गिव डिफरेंट नेम, समवन कैन कॉल देम पिंक बूथ और व्हाटएवर. वहां पे क्या होगा, वेन एवर समबडी इज असॉल्टेड, whether a known or whatever, they can directly go there. In this center, there will be lawyers, there will be police personnel, there will be prosecutor, there will be doctors. So everyone you need is present at one place. Because remember, women never go. Women kya koi nahi jata police station. Whenever a woman is assaulted, they don't seek police protection, they seek medical attention. So isliye Justice Verma Committee suggested, create one stop center, providing everything, legal aid, counseling, medical assistance, सब कुछ एक ही जगह पे होना चाहिए. बहुत अच्छा आइडिया है, पर मैं कहूंगा थोड़ा सा इसे बढ़ाया जाए और इसे बच्चों में भी ले लिया जाए. जैसे दिल्ली पुलिस ने एक इनिशिएटिव लिया था, बहुत प्यारा था, अभी भी है, नोन एज पॉक्सो ई बटन. बट एक प्रॉब्लम है, इट्स ऑनलाइन पोर्टल. देयर इज अ बॉडी इन इंडिया नोन एज प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ चिल्ड्रन फ्रॉम सेक्सुअल ऑफेंसेस, पॉक्सो, पॉक्सो एक्ट के तहत बनाई गई है. तो सॉरी, आपका एनसीपीसीआर, पॉक्सो इज द कानून इन इंडिया, देयर इज अ लॉ इन इंडिया नोन एज प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ चिल्ड्रन फ्रॉम सेक्सुअल ऑफेंसेस एक्ट. इट्स अ जेंडर न्यूट्रल लॉ. एनी चिल्ड्रन बिलो द एज ऑफ 18 इफ सेक्सुअली असोल्टेड बाय एनीवन, इट्स अ हीनियस क्राइम एंड इट हैज डिग्रीज. इट मींस इवन ट्राई टू अटेम्प्ट एन असोल्ट, नॉट असोल्टिंग, इवन ट्राइंग टू अटेम्प्ट एन असोल्ट is a punishable offense by half punishment. Matlab, for a girl child rape, for example, you have 20 years of imprisonment. Even trying to rape, you are unsuccessful, but tried, you will be getting 10 years. So, itna powerful kanun hai wo. Immediate arrest, only on a complaint, there will be immediate arrest. The girl child will be taken by the state. Child, every police station will have a child protection unit. They will take the girl child or the boy child. It's gender neutral law. They will take the child and will protect that child till required, until required, jitna bhi time lage. Iske liye what the government of India has done, Delhi police ne bahut acha kaam kiya tha. Outside every school, they placed a drop box. Any kid, they can write their complaint there and put in that drop box. And then police will take it forward without disclosing anyone's name. बच्चे क्या होते हैं, देखिए बच्चे यूजली क्या होता है, व्हेन दे सफर फ्रॉम सेक्सुअल ऑफेंसेस एट होम ना, दे ऑफन डू नॉट फील कंफर्टेबल इन टेलिंग द पेरेंट्स. क्योंकि प्रॉब्लम हमारे पेरेंट्स बात करते नहीं इन सब बारों में, उन्हें करनी चाहिए. सो दे डोंट फाइंड कंफर्टेबल, उन्हें बोलने में अच्छा नहीं लगता, हिचक होती है. दे क्राई, दे डू एवरीथिंग एंड दे स्टार्ट लिविंग स्केयर्ड. अगर किसी का सेक्सुअल असॉल्ट हो, बच्चे को समझ में तो आ जाता है पर वो बोल नहीं पाता क्योंकि डर डर के जीने लगता है वो. इन दैट सिनेरियो दिल्ली पुलिस का अच्छा इनिशिएटिव था, एक बॉक्सो बॉक्स होगा, आपको बस कंप्लेंट डालनी है और कोई भी बच्चा स्कूल के बाहर लगाए गए थे, आप जाओ उसमें कंप्लेंट डाल दो, फिर पुलिस देख लेगी उसका रैंक. ठीक है, अच्छा सजेशन था. अभी है, अगर आपको पता हो तो आप बच्चों को बता देना जिनको भी आप जानते हो. ऑनलाइन पोर्टल है नोन एज पॉक्सो ई बटन, बहुत अच्छा पोर्टल है ये पॉक्सो ई बटन. पॉक्सो ई बटन इज एन ऑनलाइन पोर्टल वेयर एनी किड, इट्स अ ग्राफिक पिक्चर. तो अगर थोड़ा कंप्यूटर आजकल बच्चों को ज्यादातर को आता ही है, यू कैन गो इन टू दिस पोर्टल, वहां पे ग्राफिक पिक्चर होती है एंड दे कैन सेलेक्ट एरियाज, पिक्चर होती है उसमें वो माउस से सेलेक्ट कर सकते हैं कहाँ कहाँ टच किया गया एंड देन दे कैन सबमिट एंड द पुलिस टेक इट फॉरवर्ड. पर ये मेरे हिसाब से ज्यादा टेक्नोलॉजी हो गई. पुलिस दिल्ली पुलिस वाला आइडिया ज्यादा अच्छा था, पुटिंग अ बैलेट बॉक्स आउटसाइड एवरी स्कूल. ठीक है, क्लियर है सबको? तो दीज आर सम इनिशिएटिव फॉर प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ चिल्ड्रन एंड अदर पीपल. अच्छे इनिशिएटिव है, क्या होगा इनका मुझे आइडिया नहीं है. ये लास्ट और ऐसे वो देख लेते हैं, रेगुलेटरी सैंडबॉक्स. हाँ, पर गौरव दीज आर टेक्नोलॉजिकल सोल्यूशन, आई एम लुकिंग फॉर मोर ग्राउंड सोल्यूशन. एनी स्कूल में था, इट वॉज इन एनी स्कूल बट नाउ इट हैज बीन डिसकंटिन्यूड. अब पता नहीं क्यों बंद कर दिया, प्रायोरिटी बदल जाती है ना, पुलिस के पास भी और काम होते हैं. अच्छा आइडिया था वैसे. Regulatory sandbox. RBI has come up with a regulatory sandbox. What is regulatory sandbox? Please remember this for prelims. Definition याद रखना. Regulatory sandbox मतलब it's a controlled environment. It's a controlled environment where new businesses or old businesses can test new financial product or services. So what is regulatory sandbox? Sandbox मतलब it's a, for example, cartoon. You are in a cartoon, so you are immune from the eyes of the world. उसी तरह से होता है. तो सर बेसिकली जैसे मान लो आप कार्टून के अंदर बैठ गए, you are inside the cartoon, nobody can see you. यहाँ पे nobody कौन है? Regulator. If you launch a credit card, debit card, financial product, तो RBI regulates that. In regulatory sandbox, there is relaxation of laws. Means you can test innovative products. मान लेते हैं यू हैव अ वेरी गुड आइडिया ऑफ अ यूपीआई. इंडिया में नोबडी यूज यूपीआई फॉर एग्जांपल, यू जस्ट गॉट एन आइडिया. सो अंडर रेगुलेटरी सैंडबॉक्स यू कैन सेलेक्ट फ्यू पीपल, यू कैन इंस्टॉल योर ऐप इन देयर फोन एंड सी हाउ इट वर्क्स, डू द ट्वीकिंग प्लस माइनस एंड परफेक्ट योर प्रोडक्ट. वंस इट इज परफेक्टेड, लॉन्च इट, देन इट विल कम आउट इन द रेगुलेशन. क्लियर है? तो रेगुलेटरी सैंडबॉक्स अलाउ अ प्रॉपर प्लेस, अ प्रॉपर एनवायरमेंट वेयर यू कैन डू innovative things till the time you are ready with a product. Clear? Online people clear hai? Baki aap padh lena yaar, isme kuch khas nahi. Any question anyone has, please ask. Nahi hai, chaliye fine then. So this is what I have for you today. We'll again meet next Saturday and till that time.
Sir?
Yes, go ahead.
Who will regulate the sandbox, sir?
Sorry?
Who will regulate, sir? Control, sir?
Regulator, it's RBI. You will read it, it's written here. Look, where is it written? You can check it out. It's RBI. Everything is written there. Prelims ke liye a suggestion. Anyone who is going to attempt prelims, so abhi to delay ho gaya. 2 months before the prelims, stop everything. Everything matlab, read nothing new. 2 months before the prelims, whenever you are going to attempt, stop everything. Do not read anything new. Revise whatever you have. There is no point of reading new when you cannot retain it. So whatever you have done, revise it again and again. There is no point of reading anything new. Clear? Huh? Everything. You may want to read a new book on anything. No, don't. Whatever you have read and revised, do it that only. No current affairs, no new book, no article, nothing new. Whatever you have done is done. Now believe in your strategy and revise. 2 months before prelims, stop everything. Leave it. leave it. Whatever, if you are gonna attempt. If you're gonna attempt 2 months before the prelims, leave it. Whatever is done, done. Whatever is not done, not done. Revise whatever is done again and again and again and again. I'm not saying you make clear, but what I'm saying, at least you have a chance to fight. In trying to attempt extra content, you will lose whatever you have. Nothing, Pawan, nothing. 2 months before prelims, abhi nahi. 2 months before prelims, leave everything and only thing you have to do, revise. Jo bhi padh liya hai, chahe current affairs kuch bhi ho, revise it again and again. Okay? Bye bye then. We will meet again.